car before we keep going?
150 an hour, is that when you base your initial proposal on?
Most of the stuff, you know, I mean, I don't think I'm not, I don't have a car. Most of the stuff, I base everything on 65 hours. And that's just, I've heard
65.
I've heard people do 55, I've heard people do 100 hours, I've heard people do 70 hours. For most of my basic, don't do an HTML, graphic design, I just do 55.
Do you have a hard time getting people paid 150 after you well, 65?
See, that's the deterrent.
Oh.
Yeah, that's prudent.
Yeah. Right.
Yeah, people do, whoa, that's a deterrent. I don't want them to get that.
Yeah.
It's a bigger point than I should. So, most of the time, it's, for example, like the guy who, we did the design, we were laying it out, we did the design, we had all the different squares. I was doing an e-commerce site with him in WordPress. And I'm using Yak just because I like the versatility of Yak. There's no deliverables or there's no product and shipping or anything. It's basically like CAD. So we have all the categories on the page. Turns out there's some fancy programs that actually do some things, but for the most part, he didn't like how all of the categories were the photos were displayed. He said, you know, and we have hundreds of categories. And he said, you know, wouldn't it be just better if we just got rid of that and just did a tree menu? And so I said, well, remember when I told you at the beginning that any type of programming changes and you got to this point, I have to tell you that no, we're not gonna do that. I said, this is one of those So when we get past the revisions, I've really tried to kind of adapt to more of our customer service. I've kind of got that point now. And I, if you follow me later on with stuff, you might hear me talk about. I'm a really big fan of, not that you've been doing this for a while, you see websites and businesses that you create and you help get going, and then a year later they're gone. And that site that you wanted to show isn't there anymore. Mm-hmm. You kind of have to honestly ask a question of yourself and say, well, did I help? You know, could I have done more to keep that business open? Because it's really easy for us to go for the next deal, for the next deal, for the next deal, because we have to pay our bills. But there's that whole Rule of 80-20 rule, right? Where you say 80% of your business goes to 20% of your clients. Well, if you're building these sites and you're going to the next one, you're not putting that effort in there. They're just lasting for a year and then they're gone. Number one, you don't have any websites to show. I mean, sure, you can show them your initial design, but when people go back and look at that site, then they're going to say, oh, well, it's not live anymore. What happened? Mm-hmm. Should we help them? Should we not help them? So I kind of have this thing, and I'll probably be talking more about it in the future, but I really kind of firmly believe that it's we need to take on some of that responsibility to make our clients successful. They're hiring us for a purpose. We don't have to either business experts, maybe that's not our role, but we have to put in that extra effort just as if it was our own site. Because if you think about that, it's really not, if they're not here tomorrow, who's responsible for it? So with the walkthrough and the education, a great form of review is set the time aside and the client walk through the site. It doesn't have to be in person. I prefer over the phone. We get to go both on our own machine. And we need to reference the original tools. You know, do a review. Like, this is what we talked about, and this is what we accomplished, and aren't you happy? And then set the time for training. I do 5 hours of training. They can do it whenever they want. And this is just typically, that's, I put a limit on that because there's been times when people have said, great, you know, we want binders put together. We want you to come to our, you know, corporation and our office, and you can give this big presentation and train a group of 20 people. And it's like, well, no, that's not what this was about. This is, I'm going to train your contactor. This is what your contactor trained somebody else with you. And that's how I've done it, because they will do that. They want you to create a school in their office, and they'll, you just have to kind of do that. So I say 5 hours, and this is one-on-one with a person, you know, your contactor yourself. Or, and that can be stretched over time. I don't put a time limit on that. If it's now, 6 months from now, whatever. I want them to feel that, you know, if they have a question, they can call me. You know, I'm the most familiar with the site. I want to help them. I want to help them succeed. So if you know, if you donate last bugs, set a date for lunch, okay, it's going to be next Tuesday. Invoice for one thing. I believe, you know, rules you've heard over the years, they have their launch on Friday. Is everyone wrong? So if you have time to talk to the host, there's always a problem. Inevitably, there will be. So I try to launch on Tuesday. Mondays are always crazy, answering all the calls. Tuesday gives you plenty of padding the rest of the week. If there's something that happens, then you can address that. And then, of course, invoice for wrong payment at this time. Let them know that as soon as I get the check, your site will go up. So,